Welcome to your Daily Revolution podcast. Today's topic, blaming referees is a sign of weakness. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
My name is Setema, the founder and creator of the Prosperity Revolution, a global movement that helps you to get out of scarcity and into prosperity every single day. A movement where people have value, things do not, where money is a result of helping people, where you're rewarded for creating value for others, and where prosperity is not the result of luck, but a predictable steps and formulas, and where happiness is the ultimate goal.
Welcome to the podcast. Grateful to be with you. Another beautiful and glorious day in Southern California. Now, you know, I was traveling back in Destin, Florida a week ago. We were there for Titan Immersion, and we went to, she's like my niece, right? Liz is my business partner's daughter. She is a baller, baller alert, future All-American. Like, she's going to be dominant. And we're in a game, right? So they're in this game, and it's like district championships, and it's like big game. And the refs were making some poor call, like, refs are not perfect. Let's just put it this way. Super Bowl, right? Buccaneers versus Chiefs. You see half of the people complaining about the refs. It happens. My son plays basketball and he is enormous and they hang on him every game and he's mad. Like, to the point of tears. He's like, they don't call anything. And so again, Chiefs, my son's game, as well as like my niece playing basketball. She's a freshman. And I notice this trend with people and with myself. Like, I'm talking to me. Every once in a while, I get angry at the refs and I start down this path of, man, the refs suck. Oh my gosh. And I can't believe, and it's the refs' fault. Look, please understand this. Okay. If you are trying to be an elite athlete, an elite performer, if you are wanting to be the best, you've got to understand this, that complaining about something you have very little control over, and these guys make decisions in a split second, they have to decide. So sometimes they're going to be wrong. Sometimes they're going to miss it. How do I know this? I was an official on many games. I went to an official camp, then I'd referee adult basketball games, and like, I get it. It's hard to be an official, whether you're in the NFL, NBA, doesn't matter what sport, like, it's hard. And if you've never been an official, then you really have no business getting on the referee's case. But here's the point. We're at this game in Florida, and I found myself getting angry. I found myself getting angry because I really thought these refs officials make some poor calls. But in a moment's notice, I had to stop myself because I thought to myself, as a coach, as a father, as a leader, what do powerful people do? And if I ever find myself complaining about referees, I know I'm not in power. I know I have now given my power over to something outside of myself, which never, ever ends well. And if you look at your own life, you got to ask yourself, am I trying to be like these parents or like Setema when I'm not powerful, who gets angry at referees? I can't believe that. See, it's easy to slip into that. It's what I call victim mode. And we start yelling at referees and we start complaining. Again, I've done this on many occasions. And I found myself on occasions where I'm like, nah, that's what a waste. But the hardest thing is, one thing as a parent, but here's the real lesson here. When an athlete, right? When an athlete's body language, their facial expressions, when they show dismay about a call an official makes, it tells me right away, they are not zoned in at the highest level of play. I saw this on the team I was cheering for, right? We're playing, we're down by, I want to say 15 or 16 points. And the body language of our athletes, they just kind of look like they gave up. And they were throwing their arms up at every call, and they would look around at everyone like, what? Are you serious? And as I observed and watched the game, I could not help. It was hard to take my coach frame off because my coach frame was like, you don't get it yet. You still don't get it. You see, the greatest athletes, they might have a little bit of that, a little disappointment. But after a while, you still got to go play the game. You still got to go make buckets. You still got to make stops in football. You still got to block and tackle and cover and execute. So whereas you might have a moment where you look at the ref and, hey, man, come on. How quickly can you get back into focus? And this is, again, one of the best things. If you find your body language, your facial expressions, if you find yourself putting responsibility on officials of a game, especially as the player, you know right away, like, it is the easiest tell you are not in power. You have given away your power. You have given away. I'm about to feel like Red Hot Chili Peppers. Give it away, give it away, give it away. Now, like, you've given it away. Can't do that. You see, you know what the most powerful people do? They don't do that. They stay focused on executing and doing their job. They stay focused on, like, really digging in. Again, I'm going back to the basketball game here. Right? We were down 15, 16 points, and then something happened. One of our players flipped a switch and turned it on. There was a strategy that finally went into play. They put the full court press on and they pressed them. We brought the deficit down to 4 points. And then I think we lost by 6 or 7, but it was amazing to see the shift. What would have happened had we kicked it into gear sooner than later? We probably have a chance. But the biggest lesson of many lessons in the game is, where in your life are you blaming external things outside of you that you have no control over? Like, you don't have control over a referee. You could yell at him. You could scream at him. And as an official, I've been an official. Half the people are going to love you. Half the people are going to hate you. And you got to make a split, like, in a moment's decision, you got to make a call from your perspective. So while it's easy for me as a fan, as a father in the stands to get mad when the refs don't call things against my son, because people do hang on him. I got the video to prove it. It doesn't help, because the moment I start saying those dang refs, I can't believe this, I change my language back into a place of power. I say, hey, what do you got to do? Let's focus, okay? And I often just tell my son, look, send a message. Like, put an elbow in a kid's mouth if he's hanging on you. Now, I know some of you are like, I can't believe you said that. It's sports. You've never played sports. You don't understand. And so, like, try not to judge me here too harshly. But I told my son, look, if they're going to hang on you, then let them know what a real foul looks like. And let them know, like, they can't do that. Now, that's a whole nother podcast. The purpose of me sharing this podcast is, too many people out there today are like these parents, are like myself, where I want to blame the refs. You're still trying to blame your parents? You're still trying to blame who's in the White House? You're still trying to blame politicians in office? You're still trying to blame the color of your skin? Are you still trying to blame something that happened to someone across the country that you only see news stories about, that you really don't know how true it is because there's such a deeply driven propaganda and message driven by media? Like, do you get that? Are you still trying to blame everything and anything out there? Or, as a powerful person would do, are you willing to take 100% responsibility? Oh, I don't have any money. That's on you. Oh, my marriage isn't working. That's on you. And even, let's say, even if your spouse steps out on you, even if that happens, what are you going to do about it? Even if one of your teenage children is, I guess the word is wayward, right? Maybe not on the path that you would hope that they'd be on. Are you willing to just take responsibility and focus on solving the problem, focus on learning and understanding? Or are you going to sit there and blame and complain like a victim and make excuses? When it comes to your health, there's nobody in your house with a gun to your head forcing you to starve yourself or to eat the junk food that you eat. There's no one forcing you, like, you cannot work out, you can't go for a walk. Like, you got so much power. You got more power than you understand. Like, it's on you, my friends, to stop being a victim. Stop blaming referees. Stop blaming your genetics. Stop blaming, you know, your generational whatever. Like, look, I heard this from a good friend of mine. His name is Jose. Great speaker. He's in a wheelchair. He's awesome. I'm going to say he's Jose Inspires on Instagram. And he spoke at one of our events about 6 months ago. And he said a line that I've never forgotten. It was so impactful when he was to the point of, like, your generations have been waiting for you to wake up and break the chains. And I'm like, wow. So that's what I do. Like, it doesn't matter that I have brown skin. It doesn't matter that I'm Polynesian. It doesn't matter that I did not come from super wealthy family. If I didn't come from a super financially wealthy family, then it's my job to make sure that I do come from one and that I create one. It doesn't matter that maybe things are stacked against me. Give me the chips on my shoulder and let me go to work. Let you go to work physically. Are you still blaming the lack of diet and the lack of nutrition and the lack of time? Or will you just take responsibility and own the fact that you are where you are because that's what you've chosen spiritually? Own it. It's not anyone's fault out there, but it's on you and it's on your shoulders and within your responsibility, within your hands to go do the work. Relationally, if your marriage sucks, well, you got a choice. Fix it, fight for it, work on it, and pay a price for it. You know, I know people who, you know, they've been a jerk. They've been like an a-hole. I don't want to be, I'm going to keep this one G-rated here. But they haven't been a good spouse for years. And then one day they're like, man, I'm going to change. You ought to be willing to fight for as long as you've been an a-hole. You ought to be willing to just fight for that long to show and earn the trust of your spouse and your children. Right? It's on you. So go fight for it. Be willing to, right, as all the love songs say, you know, climb the steepest mountains, cross the widest seas, go through the darkest pits, if that's the thing that you really want. And of course, financially, it's on you, my friends. It's not about pandemics and lockdowns. I get it, man. We've all felt the sting of it. I know that there are people in places that have locked you down, that have like stymied and stifled your business. But guess what? There's always a way. There's always a way. And you've got to get out of the energy of, ref, you suck. Now, look, I don't mind saying that. That's like part of the game. That's kind of fun. You'll catch me, boo, I'll boo the refs all day. But at the end of the day, I'm going to keep my energy focused on what? What I control, especially as a player. Especially as a player in the game. I don't care. I'm like, you can call fouls against me all day. I'm just going to out-hustle. I'm going to out-strategize. I'm going to out-work. And I'm just going to grind and hustle on the sports, on the football field, on the basketball court. And the same thing goes in your business. Figure it out. Stop blaming. Stop complaining. Stop making excuses. Stop putting responsibility on the shoulders of other people that it doesn't really matter because it's not on them. It's on who? It is on you, my friends. 100% on you. I appreciate you listening. If you've got something out of this, two things. Share this. Take a screenshot. Share it with a friend. Forward it and let someone know. Like, dude, let's stop complaining about the refs. Let's stop complaining about the economy, about the politics. If you're not willing to do something about it, stop complaining. The second thing, if this has been useful and helpful, I invite you to check out our Champions Huddle, championshuddle.com. That's our monthly coaching where we talk strategies, business building, really for entrepreneurs and business owners, and for those who want to go to another level. Now, we are going to be opening up another program, really not designed for business owners, but for people who are just getting on the path of personal growth and development. Look out for those announcements as we release that. But championshuddle.com, let me know what you got from this. I appreciate you listening. God bless you. Have an amazing day. Until next time.
Let's go. This is your daily revolution. Live in prosperity. We show you how to do it. There's no luck about it. We got the strategic blueprint. This is the your daily revolution. You already know. And if you don't, then check my resume. Turning pressure into possibilities every day. We all can win and live our unique purpose. Change our mindsets and put the work in. This is the your daily revolution. Daily revolution. Revolution. Your daily revolution podcast.